tells them that while you're standing still, you don't have to worry about what's going to happen. For the Lord is going to fight your battle. And I don't know about you, but I'm feeling pretty good to know that if God is going to fight my battle, has anybody here heard that if God be for you, he's more than the whole world against you? I'm glad today to know that
what
God
time is communion?
Will
communion
fight
is at what
my
time?
Battle. If you're going to move from a desperate situation to a divine destination, you have to let go of your past. You have to let go of your fear. And thirdly and lastly, the writer tells us that we got to let go and let God. Is there anybody here today that's willing to let go and let God? Is there anybody here today that is willing to let God work it out? I'm glad today that I can call on God to fix my problems. He's bread when I'm hungry. He's water when I'm thirsty. When I'm sick, he's a doctor. He's a healer. I can call on him early in the morning. I can call on him late in the midnight hour. And I'm glad, and I'm glad that God, he's able to fix my problem. Here in this text, it tells us that he speaks to Moses, and he says, Moses, why is it that you're crying out to me? We got to learn that when we're going through difficulty, we got to learn when situations that show up that are disheartening, we got to learn that God's promise, it does not change. If he said it, it's going to come to pass. God is not a man that he shall lie. If you hold on, if you hold out, after a while, by and by, he will make everything all right. Here we go. We talked about his promise, and then he moves into the text about God's power. He says, Moses, you're crying out to me, but I've given you everything that you need. I told you to go down to Egypt and tell that mean old Pharaoh to let my people go. When you got there, you said you couldn't talk. I gave you your brother Aaron. Go down and tell that mean old Pharaoh to let my people go. I brought you out, and now that you're out here in the wilderness, the people run into some difficulties. I want you to remind them that you didn't bring them out, but I brought them out. And I brought them out, I'm able to lead them in. Somebody here missed it. Somebody here missed their shower. Right now, the difficulty that you're going through, the trouble that showed up at your door, if God led you to it, he can lead you out of it. If he talked you to it, he can take you out of it. All you got to do is hold on to God's unchanging hand. Moses, stretch out your hand. Moses stretched out his hand, and the water started to stack up. Does anybody here know that God has all power in his hand? I'm glad today to know that he has all power in his hand. and didn't want anybody to worship anybody but him. He said when the music started to play, that everybody was to bow down and worship the golden image. Somebody in the kingdom said, you know them three Hebrew boys, them three Negroes that you got in charge of everything. They're not bowing down. The king said, what? They're not bowing down. Go get them Negroes and bring them to me. I heard that the Hebrew boy told him, said, oh king, we're careful to tell you, but we will not bow down to your golden image. The king said, since you won't bow down, I'm going to cast you into the fiery furnace. They knocked Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego down to the fiery furnace. The Bible says that they turned it up so high that the men that were walking with them were killed, they were burned, their hair was singed. They cast them into the fire. I like the part of the text that says when they cast them into the fire, that they cast them in and they were bound. Their feet were tied, their hands were tied. Somebody right now here, today, your feet is tied, your hands is tied, and you have been cast into the fire. But I've got good news for you all today. The fire might be hot, but if God is on your side, He will make everything all right. The king went down. He looked into the furnace. He said, I know I put Shadrach in there. I know I put Meshach in there. I know I put Abednego in there. But there's somebody else in there. And he looks like the Son of God. I stopped by to tell you that the Son of God will show up with you in the fire if you let go and let God. Come here, David, and though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table in the presence of my enemy. Wait a minute, Lord. You're preparing a table in the presence of my enemy. I like that about God. You'll prepare a table in front of your enemy and invite your enemy to watch you being blessed. Ain't God all right? I'm glad today that I walk with a true and a living God. My light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? He is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? When the wicked and my enemies came upon me to eat up my flesh, they stumbled and they fell. I came by to tell you, if you're going to move from a death